The situation today is obviously very exceptional. Luxury has been suffering the whole year because of the closure of stores and because also of the closure of travel retail worldwide. And business to travel retail is recovering, but very, very slowly. At the same time, we saw a strong rebound on other channels. One of them is, as you said, professional products. We said, by the way, a few months ago that it would bounce back, and it's happening. We see also some good bounce back on the mass market business and the consumer division, and of course a stellar performance of active cosmetic that is growing at a fantastic speed all over the world. And so it's we are happy with this performance, especially because if you take out travel retail, because travel retail of course is pretty difficult right now. If you take out travel retail, our total growth for the quarter will be plus 5%, which is a good rhythm.
And do you see, looking forward, do you see these trends continuing into Q4, and how sustainable are they? And I'm thinking also working from home, masks wearing. This trend seems to be here to stay, at least well into 2021. So that's affecting, of course, the sale of makeup, for example, and perfume. So are you adapting your business to adapt to these new consumer trends and potentially even adapting your portfolio?
No, we are not changing our portfolio because, you know, you have to be careful not changing your long-term strategy just for a short-term difficulty. So I'm very confident about makeup on the middle and long term. Definitely in the very short term, during the COVID crisis, makeup is impacted, but it's reasonably impacted. It's not a drama. And at the same time, we have other categories that are doing very well, and like skincare, like hair color, like hair care. And I really believe that once the COVID-19 crisis will be behind us, and this will happen, I don't know exactly when, but this will happen, I hope in the middle of next year, we will be back to a good growth also of categories like fragrances and makeup. So we are not changing our strategy long term for the short term solution.
China, which has been one of the main engines for growth in some previous quarters for you, seems to have paid off again with a good growth this quarter. How much of a momentum do you see continuing inside the Chinese market?
You know, you have to separate clearly the Chinese market itself and our performance in China. The market, the global beauty market, in fact, is, of course, better than anywhere else in the world, but it's not fantastic. You know, the beauty market year to date in China is probably around plus minus zero. The last quarter was plus 7% in China for the market, but you know, year to date we are at zero. The great performance, of course, is the performance of L'Oréal, because on this market we have a gap between our performance and the market around 20%. In this last quarter, we were able to grow at plus 28%, when the market was at plus 7. So we are really gaining market share in the four divisions. Luxury is booming again. Mass market is strong. Professional products is really growing fast, and same for active cosmetics. So this is really our performance in China that is really exceptional.